So Rochdale 13 with Chris Riley after a landmark appearance here at the Crown Oil Arena. You made it 250 appearances finally after a long wait, and you got over for your 150th try. How good did that feel?
Yeah, no, it was a great moment for me. So when you look back in your start of your career, and I think my debut was in 2005, and to go on and make 250 appearances was a great moment, and also to get the 150th try was obviously a sweet one as well. But yeah, coming back from, I think it's been 10 weeks with my injuries, with my hand and my foot, obviously been disappointing to be watching the boys on the sideline and missing out on a few big games in York and Toulouse. So to get back out there today, I was a bit nervous in the aspect of how fit I was going to be fair, but no, got out there, got a good 80 minutes under my belt and ready to go on for next week.
It's a tough game to come back in as well against the good Doncaster side. Do you think that helped as well?
Yeah, no, they're a good side and obviously a top eight side, and we knew it was going to be a tough game, and yeah, it plays in the back of your mind a little bit to see what level I was actually at. But no, I felt good out there. I think the last 10 minutes I was treading water a little bit, and I was hoping that killer would bring me off with the game being obviously we had it won. But yeah, it was good to get out there with the boys. I've missed it, you know. It's what you look forward to at the end of the week. You know, now I'm doing full-time work, you appreciate the rugby at the end of the week. So yeah, it's been a tough 10 weeks, but you know, to get out there today and get the win was nice.
And obviously you've bounced back from back-to-back defeats as well. How important was that you came here in front of the home fans and got back to winning ways?
Yeah, we obviously knew them two games was going to be a big point for our season, really. You know, it would have been nice to get a couple of points from at least one of them games, you know, but wasn't to be. And, you know, it was important that we bounced back after two, what I think are the contenders for promotion this year, in Toulouse and York. And, you know, it was always going to be tough games, but to get back against Doncaster today, what was never going to be an easy game, was good. Obviously, I think we started really well with the kickoff. We got the ball back and we scored in that first set, but you know, they really put it on us and went in the lead, and we had to regroup and put our minds together, and we really put a good game together there in the end. I think a good period in that second half really put us in good stead, you know, and got a good win in the end.
You forced your way back into the game at the end of the first half, and you got yourself level going into the break. What was it that was said at half time that made you come out and be so strong in the second period?
Just a bit of composure, really. I think it was a bit frantic in good ball area. You know, had a couple of sets where probably I think we went into touch first and second tackle and dropped a few balls by force. And you know, we didn't really need to at that point. You know, game's not over in the first 40 minutes, but you know, we built after that, and Killer had a couple of words at half time. Mainly just keep composed and you know, when we got too involved with decisions on the field, you know, we needed to keep playing our own game, and I think we did that in the second half and really got on the front foot. And I don't think Doncaster could live with us at that little period we had in that second half, which really put us in the lead.
And you've got Huns up next week. How important is it that you take some momentum into that and have another good performance?
Yeah, no, it's massive. You know, Huns are a really, very strong side. They've got some great players. You know. It was a long while ago when we last played them, but you know, we had a really good, tough game here. You know, we got them here again, and you know, we're expecting a real tough game. And it'd be good for us, really, to be fair. You know, going into the semi-finals the week after that, you know, we could have a little trip to Toulouse. You never know with that game in the balance, you know, between us and Barrow. So it's important that we get the 2 points and give ourselves a chance of that automatic promotion game.
Cheers, Chris.
Cheers, mate. Thank you.